Getting from passive to active analytics is a process that takes building blocks and has really powerful outcomes. Let's first start out with what the building blocks are. We have passive analytics, and then we need to build on top of that with reactive analytics, then augmented analytics, and finally, you can get all the way up to active analytics. With passive analytics, that's generally more report-centric, more rigid pipelines, and that is where a lot of traditional BI start. And we can get only about 20% of decisions end up being data-driven as a result of that. That was greatly improved on about a decade ago with more reactive style of analytics centered around interactive dashboards, where users could freely explore and see insights. But they needed some skills to do that. And that got us to about 20 to 30% of decisions could be data-driven. We then enhanced the reactive analytics by augmenting it with AI so that more users could, with lower skill levels could then have better insights, as well as the higher skilled users would be able to see more. And that got us to 30 to 40%. We've now added active analytics to capabilities, and that can get us over 50% of decisions will be made that are data driven. So ultimately, what we've done is we've moved from analytics ready to business ready. As we've moved up to be more active in the way analytics are, we've moved closer to real-time decision making, instead of just historic decision making. So what are the components that go into being active in your analytics decision? Well, first of all, you need to make sure that there's collaboration. Various analytics users need to be able to share their insights they're seeing, as well as add to the visualizations and the body of knowledge. While dashboards still remain important, going beyond the dashboard becomes really important, and you need to be mobile as well as embedded. By embedding directly in to business processes, the analytics now becomes part of the business decision process and not something that's done separately at a different time. And finally, and most importantly, active analytics needs to trigger action. That's done in two key ways. One is automating things, and the other is alerting individuals of what they need to do and prescribing the approach they need to take. So, by building on what you already have, moving from passive to reactive to augmented and active, having collaboration, mobile and embedded, and triggering action, you can move from passive to active analytics.